Hey, everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eden Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victor Repentance series. Happy 1,000 episodes, everybody. I wasn't going to do anything wacky or crazy because I figured the only fitting way to celebrate 1,000 episodes in a YouTube series is just to keep on doing what we're doing, and that's exactly what we're going to do. So thank you all very much. Sincerely, since the Rebirth era began, all the way up through the Repentance era, Isaac has definitely done anything and everything to improve my life, and I couldn't be happier with where everything is. And again, I thank you all very much for the journey. Here's to another 1,000. We're just going to keep on going. We did have another video across 3,000 likes. Now puts us only 15 away from TM Trainer Month. And also, here's your amazing mosh pet of the day here, this time brought to you by Fredward Kroger. Title of the thread was First Snake Here. Yeah, this is definitely the first mosh pit snake, I would say. And they also said, longtime viewer, first time poster. I hope I'm not too late to contribute to the mosh pets. I've seen a few lizards and birds, but how about a nice noodle? This is Carmelo, the ball python. I like letting him cruise around when I watch daily Isaac video. He's just a bit over a meter long. It might be the friendliest snake I've ever known. That is awesome. Thank you very much, Carmelo and Fredward, and everyone who upvoted that one. I had a lot of comments on that one on the subreddit as well. Go check out the subreddit. We're almost at 25,000 people over there as well. Very awesome. Ooh. He is going to be Golf 7, Victor 1, Sierra 0, X-Ray 7. We got pretty good stats here, except our movement speed is kind of doo-doo. Starting off with Mega is always fun, especially when we're going to have Deadeye. Obviously, Deadeye does not synergize with Mega, but it is a very good... it's a good alternative to when we finally do get rid of Mega, right? Because we don't have to worry about our damage at all. We don't have to worry about our tears rate. We don't have to worry about anything. Mega also, starting off with Mega early on is going to be a very, very good thing. Why did you go that way? I want to know why the AI sent you that way when all the other ones were following the pattern of going the correct way. But starting off with Mega also opens up a lot of early doors. Not only does it give us very, very fast clears for levels, but also it allows us to get something like Nun's Habit or something like, say, Void, where we can reduce the cooldown of Mega even more, because obviously 12 is a really hefty amount of charges to get on a spacebar item. But Mega, obviously, you want something like Car Battery. You want something like, oh my goodness, you want something like Jumper Cables, especially, is very, very good, very strong. 4.5 volt obviously is going to be the top tier that you can get from Mega. But overall, like, you want to have as many possible ways to give you more charges on Mega than not. And I would say the easiest way to do that is definitely getting something like Nun's Habit, which I will try to get anyway. I don't know if we're going to have enough money for it. Probably not. Looking for the secret room, which is right here. Hopefully there's a decent amount of money in here. There's not. Maybe get a key so we can open up another one of those golden chests. Okay, well, we did get a bomb. Now we're hovering around 9 cents. So we're working on it. I'm going to drop a bomb here to maybe get the super secret room. No, never mind. It can't be there. Don't listen to me. Another damage upgrade. Wow, this is a crazy first floor. Yeah, I think it's pretty much donezo unless we go buy another bomb over here and then get, or not a bomb, but a key, and then get inside of that golden chest or not. All right. One last Hail Mary here. Maybe we'll get a dime or something out of there. We did get a lot of money. Wow, we are going to be able to get Nun's Habit. That's actually incredible. Considering where we started to on this floor was zero to actually getting Nun's Habit, that's insane. We can actually also game the system a little bit here and just get a couple extra charges on Nun's Habit. I think that's a good idea. There we go. Went down to a half heart because we have this other half heart over here. So we're going to start off the next floor essentially We're going to start off the next floor essentially with a full charge on Mega, although I didn't realize it. I forgot that heart was trapped behind rocks, so we just got to be a little bit careful, but we got Mega. Come on now. So yeah, 1,000 episodes of a YouTube series is quite insane. I think that Isaac is literally the only series that I've ever had that has done that multiple times now. Because obviously we did 1,000 episodes in Afterbirth. I don't remember if we did 1,000 episodes in Rebirth or not. Gotta pick up that heart here. See, right there would have been great for not car battery, but jumper cable. So I'm going to quickly move on over here. We just barely got Larry here, and we got our HP back with a couple soul hearts thanks to Mom's Pearls. And we will also take the Pact, which is going to give us even more damage. And Ease Mascara, this is truly the game being in a celebratory mood, I would say. I probably should have actually used that, but oh well. The damage is done. We still need a Yave, though. Necesito mucho Yave. Okay. We could go into the curse room, but we're not going to get any keys out of that unless one randomly drops from clearing it, which I wouldn't hold our breath at. Okay. So we're going to end up skipping not only the entire floor, but the shop and a library. Unless somehow fortune-telling machine gives us either a stars card or a hermit card, preferably a stars card. Actually, no, what we'd really want is a justice card. Okay. So anyway, we'll go on to the last week's question of the episode, the most upvoted question asked by the Mosh Pit, this time sent in by Amprize. I think it's Amprize. Question first, Invicta, if you could add your own item to Isaac, what would it be and what would it do? This is a very common question that I get in stream a lot, and it's hard for me to answer it because, like, I don't have anything that's, like, loaded up in the memory banks ready to fire off like a good answer, but generally speaking, I don't have like a catchy name for it or anything, but I would love to see an item that permanently boosts your stats based on you playing well, like, so not taking damage in a room. It's kind of like Pascal Candle in a way, except it helps out with permanent stats. And we're talking about incremental stats. We're not talking about anything crazy here. I got the timing off of my brain. There we go. Something that would be a permanent all stats up every now and then. And I know that people are going to say, "Oh, it sounds like Death's List." Kind of in a way, because obviously, like, you have to play well in order to gain any benefit from Death's List. But this would be a little bit more extreme in the sense that, like, if you clear a room without taking damage, instead of you, like, making, like, accurate shots or getting screwed over by something that flies into something else, or if it spawns something, they instantly die. This way allows you to get rewarded on simply just playing well. So think of it like little mini. It would turn every room into a mini game, essentially, is what I'm trying to get at. One bomb for 10 cents is absolutely worth it. Especially after we missed that last shop there. Last entire floor, really. That's what I would create. I don't know what I would call it. I do think that within this Invicta mod, which we haven't played in quite a while, like a year now, or maybe two. In this Invicta mod, the mod creator also created a couple of extra items in there. One of them was the full clear certificate, which essentially gave you a benefit for exploring the entire map. That kind of stuff is really neat and interesting. It's not overpowered, but it's funny. It vibes well with the characters, and also it does benefit the player, like, not greatly, but something insane, or not insane, but something unique. And that's what I would want to make as far as, like, an item of mine. I would love to see it just be like, hey, if you don't take damage in this room and in every subsequent rooms, you gain stats. And the more rooms that you clear without taking damage, the higher that your stats are amplified. Now you could do something, if you didn't want permanent. I mean, if I was in charge, I would make them permanent upgrades. Like, maybe, like, a stat up goes like, it starts off with, like, the first three rooms that you complete without taking damage, you know, you get like a 0.1 random stat upgrade. And then after three rooms, it goes up to, let's say a 0.4 random stat upgrade. I'm going to go all the way back and check for a planetarium because we obviously skipped a lot in that last floor. And then if you get to like a streak of like 10 or 20 rooms that you haven't been hit in, or maybe an entire floor, you get a bonus, a stat bonus. It goes up to one stat, one whole stat up or something like that. You know, something crazy like that. I think that would be very, that would be, not only would that add a very interesting dynamic to the quote skill play of Isaac, but also it's greatly beneficial and helps out the player. The better you are, the more benefit you get. As opposed to something like Death's List, where you essentially just have, you know, yeah, you might get a stat up or a consumable if you're lucky. If you're lucky enough to not get screwed by something spawning on top of something else and then dying instantly, you know, like, I think my item would be considered much more stronger and much better for the player than something like Death's List that can randomly just be like, nah, you're done, you know. So that's what I would do. And thank you very much, Amprize, for the question of the episode. And remember, submit your own question of the episodes down below and upvote your favorite ones. Twenty-five damage here, absolutely rocking the damage meters. If this were WoW or something like that, we'd be crushing it right now. Love to get some movement speed if possible. I would also love to go the right way if possible. At least we're getting fast room clears here, so we can keep up with the charge on Mega. You know, you're always going to be kind of at the mercy of, are we going the right way with Mega or not? And in this case, I think that, you know, if we can manage to get enough money. If we can get enough money to keep Mega going with like something like charging the jumper cables, you know, we might even be able to get something that like deals damage to Isaac, but like also charges something like, say, I don't know, maybe the IV bag, or, you know, combined with Nun's Habit, that's a good way to get yourself a lot of easy charges. Ideally, we would just get Void. Ideally, we would just get Void, and that would be it. Because Void, again, just it cuts the cooldown in half, and is also just, you know, it's going to give us even more stat ups. Wow, I can't believe that made it. Not only did it make it all the way there, but like also like we just happened to time it like perfectly to where that thing was going to hit us. Shot speed is doo doo. I mean, our only doo doo stats are essentially just our shot speed and movement speed. Like there's no speed at all here. Bombs are something that we have been a little bit lacking on ever since that first floor. There's Tendon Rock in here, but we can't do anything about it. Love to get some money. Secret room is there, by the way, but again, we have no bombs, so... Now, we could play the Sacrifice Room, but there's not enough HP to really warrant that, in my opinion. This is 5 cents, but I'm not going to do anything with it. The Sun card, it turns all of our heart containers into bone hearts, and we also get flying, basically Spirit of the Night for the entire floor. If we needed flying, I guess we could go pick it up, like this bomb here. We can go ahead and use it. Now with Spirit of the Night, this allows us to possibly maybe play the Sacrifice Room. Because of the bone hearts. They're a lot easier to refill than the red hearts are. And also we can get a full tap off of just a half heart instead of it going down to, you know, one full heart container. We just go down to half heart and still maintain the bone heart, which is very nice. Another bomb, so it's good. Starter deck. I don't really want to use my bomb on just that. Let's go fight the boss and let's see where we're at here. There's not really enough hearts for me to really warrant consideration for the Sacrifice Room play. I don't really want to use our soul hearts for that if we're not going to be able to guarantee a full tap. So obviously we're not going to use Mega here especially against Rag Mega with Deadeye being active. We're just going to just smash him real quick. What was that? Okay, we get meat. Now, meat definitely might put us over the edge here. So We get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. You would have to get Soul Hearts and one more Red Heart in order for us to do a full tap. It's very close. We also might be able to get an HP upgrade inside of the boss trap room. I don't want to waste too much time here because obviously we're trying to make boss rush. Let's see what we get out of this. Oh, and there's a half heart in here. Okay, so that puts us at 12. And we don't even need 12. We just need 11. So this is what I'm talking about right here really fast. So notice, keep an eye on our bone hearts right now. Okay, so we're going to tap. It's going to take one full heart away, and they're going to be left with a bone heart. Okay. Now what we do is we take a half heart, and watch this. It won't go down to 1.5 bone hearts now. It's going to stay at 3 bone hearts, or 3 HP, because we're not actually technically spending the bone heart yet. So half hearts are really where it's at in terms of value. We get another half heart here. That's great. Get Genesis. Interesting, but not really what we're looking for. Now here's the problem with doing this, and you probably already see it happening. If we lose a bone heart, we lose our permanent HP containers. Remember, we're doing this only because we have this temporary reverse sun card. So as soon as these bone heart break, that's it. And we will not get those back. So we're going for a very, very, very hefty investment in making this play work. Genesis is interesting. I'm not going to tap this. I'm just going to let the bombs expire. We maybe could get another heart here. Obviously, we're trying to avoid spending the bone hearts if possible, but we're not going to be able to save all of them. Unless we get some hearts in the super secret room or something like that. Okay, dice shard. Dice shard is also going to give us a reroll. So now, well, it's actually great for us because now we can get both of the angel statues and get the keys in there, then reroll them with dice shard and reroll Genesis. I don't think I want to use Genesis here. We have a very strong build. There is no reason for us to use Genesis other than just being wacky. You see that key up there? Give me that key. Okay, so we could also, if we really have to, spend these two bombs and maybe get a heart from the bomb beggar. We're trying to minimize the amount of damage here from losing a bone heart. Okay, so there's that, and then we only have to tap two more times to get Gabriel. Had a chance to be a big time player there, Bomb Beggar. Is there a heart inside of the shop? There is. Okay. We might be able to get away without losing any bone hearts, which is ideal. The only thing that we're not going to be able to do is go inside of the boss trap room, which would be fine. Yeah, so this is going to give us either soul hearts. That's fine. Now we don't have to worry about the red hearts anymore. We go destroy Gabriel real quick. And then we use the dice shard. And I honestly, C-section mom's knife is huge. That is a ton of damage. The only thing bad is our tears rate, but man, C-section, Deadeye, mom's knife. Holy moly. That is a metric butt ton of damage right there. And we don't even need... The crazy thing is that we don't even need C-section to be charged at that point with Deadeye. It's just going right out the box. It's just going to be doing buku damage. All right, so... Got ourselves quite the banger run here. Forgot we don't have flying. Necessito flying. crazy to me that you can't pick up Eternal Hearts, but for some reason you can pick up Red Hearts with Mega. We have a bomb, unfortunately, for that Tinted Rock. Not that we really need it, but it'd be nice to have. Oh, baby. Now we're cooking. Champion Belt and 4.5 volt. Holy moly. We hit that Spike Rock, huh? So Champion Belt's obviously going to just give us a straight-up damage upgrade, and then obviously having the having 4.5 volt with this build here and Mega, is, I mean, every single hit that we get is going to give us almost one full pip of energy on our active item. A very fitting run for episode 1000. We start off with, you know, with one of the most powerful space primes in the entire game. We get ourselves a mega crazy run, no pun intended, in terms of damage. And it would be nice if we can get a mega run out of this. I wouldn't mind that. Yeah, quite the way to ring in the next 1,000 episodes of The Binding of Isaac. Oh my gosh. Okay. Well, I'm going to take Cammy Conception, and I'm going to take Brimstone, because now not only do we not have to worry about the tier's cooldown of C-section, but we also fire multiple babies very quickly in rapid succession. And on top of all that, we still get Brimstone. So, yeah, this is getting out of control in a hurry. Okay, I actually do want to make boss rush here. So, wow. Yeah, this is going to get a 10 on the Jasonator dunk rating for sure. And we're only 18 minutes into this run, and we're only on Dank Depths 1. We haven't even begun this run yet. Okay, so object here, find the fool card, get to the mom fight. And we have gone every which possible wrong way to do that with. And there's also nothing to kill. Okay. It's the world's most empty depths. That is insane that we only got 2 charges out of all that, and we cleared how many rooms? This is the game trying to stop us from doing what we want to do. In the world's most delayed mom hands as well. Okay, we got our fool card. All we gotta do is just find the mom fight here. And we've gone the wrong way. Alright. Right. Gonna be down, isn't it? Rainbow champion over there. Not sure why Dumpy decided to activate, but we are not going to make boss rush, are we? Oh, we might. Be close. Oh, yeah. We're fine. We even have time to go into the devil deal. Look at this. Finally get ourselves a movement speed upgrade. Good lord. And we got Leviathan. I might as well just take Death's Touch. It is going to destroy our tears rate a little bit, but that's okay. And Rubber Cement or just a straight up damage upgrade. Or we could go Compound Fracture. I don't remember if Compound Fracture works with C-section or not. Look at that weird texture at the base of the animation for Mega. See that? You see that? Like, it looks like a print line from a Pokemon card. I don't know if it shows up on the encoder or not. Death's Touch now making skull babies, of course, which is really cool in metal. You can actually stack the charges of Mega if you wanted to. Grab all this money. We don't care about wasting the cooldown of Mega here. Obviously, we don't care about Data Miner at all. Let's go check the curse room real quick here. I mean, if you look at our items right now, it looks like we just gave ourselves a whole bunch of good items, you know? Like, how do we win this run in the fastest, easiest way possible? I mean, starting off with Deadeye, getting Ease Mascara into Stapler Nun's Habit, and then the Packed, Squeezy, Meat. I mean, it is insane. And then C-Section, Mom's Knife, Brimstone, and the Mark is, like, all these items are... We're getting an all-star cast here for episode 1,000 of Repentance. There ain't a dang thing the game's going to be able to do about it. Can't believe the secret room wasn't there. Must be a more obvious spot. Maybe to the left of that big elbow room. Could be here too. Could also be here. Okay, I give up. I don't care anymore. Sagittarius is going to give us some movement speed. Again, something we desperately need and we still need. We'll go to the shop here real quick. Maybe we can get some mapping. That'd be nice. Eventually, we will need a school bag if we're going to try for an Omega run. I mean, there's no indication right now that we're going to get an Omega run. Would be nice, but... I'm going to go ahead and drop the sun card because we just flat out just do not need it. An absolute no. I forgot that we took PhD too. I always forget that we take PhD. Pretty fly. Go back and go get that pill real quick. I'm sure I probably skipped a bunch of pills already. Just because I'm not accustomed to taking them. By default, I'll go into autopilot and just skip them all. Hey, tears up. Nice-oo. Sun card, again, we don't need you. Thanks for showing up. Appreciate all the help that you gave us on that first floor, but not first floor, but you know your way out, right? This is a very, very odd place. I do not know where the secret room is. Above the boss trap room, maybe? Can't be there. I mean, I guess it could. No, I already tried there, didn't I? Did I try here? I don't remember if I did or not. Okay. That's still a very odd spot for it. Very odd Todd of a spot. Come on, Todd. Stop being so odd. We're going to head on down, and yeah, there is nothing that the game's going to be able to throw at us that's going to threaten us at all. Glad I didn't pop Mega right away, because the game is still trying to waste our time. As soon as I saw this room, I knew that this was going to be a dead end. Okay, good. Okay, here we go. And honestly, I'm down with a womb skip. You don't really gain much benefit here. After womb one, I mean. Yeah, let's do a little bit of a womb skip. I am gonna go fight the boss, obviously, because there's no reason not to. I'll teleport to the angel room. That's fine. Soul heart here. Oh, I was really hoping for the soul hearts, but what can you do? What can you do? Our movement speed is so slow that we're being outrun by the spikes there. I guess technically there's nothing the game could do to threaten us, but obviously we're our own worst enemy here. And by the way, you do see the brittle bones or compound fracture going hand here. Where those babies go? Those babies just, they're going, they, their planet needs them. It's weird how they just sped up like that. Oh man. I guess like if they find a target, they just go ham. And then if there's no target, they just kind of like just leave. Well, we're going to need an HP upgrade in order for us to do a womb skip. Dumpy. HP upgrade here. I mean, Uncle Holy Water. I mean, it's great to see Uncle Holy Water. Don't get me wrong. Like, you know, it's always good to see our uncle. Thank you, Dumpy. Obviously, we don't really need the key piece because we're about to fight Gabriel anyway. Yeah, but I kind of want to keep the Eternal Heart. Okay. Get ourselves a Soul Heart, which we might as well take. The new rule is that I'm not going to use Mega until I know for a fact that we're at least going in what looks to be maybe the correct way. It says as he instantly goes into a dead end. Okay, another HP upgrade there with less than 3, it's good. Hey, really, if you want to think of it, did she actually get a brimstone off there? Wow. That's insane to me. I'm going to take Guppy's Paw. Obviously, we're going to take Empty Vessel here. We can use Guppy's Paw. Then we still have this HP upgrade that we have from Gluttony here. Maybe there's a pill in here. Not. Sparge Key. Okay, so Hush, we gotta go fight old Hushy, and Hush is not gonna last too long. We got boss rush done. We're about to get Hush done. We still don't have an R key, so if we don't find an R key on the next lap, we're pretty much sunk. We also need a school bag and maybe Diplopia. I mean, does Tech X? I don't remember if Tech X even works with. I don't remember what this looks like. Oh yeah, it does. Okay. Yep. Friend Finder. I mean, Friend Finder is great, but yeah, this is. If it wasn't already out of control, it's even more out of control now. We're spiraling out of control. Empress card here is gonna help us eat old Hushy real quick. We might not even have to use Mega at this point. Oh my gosh. Yeah, that's Yep. I'm still going to use Mega because obviously it fires a lot faster than C-section and, oh my god, Isaac, thank you. Fires a lot faster than C-section and Tech X. You love how many lengths the game is going through to make sure that we can't get like a full spread of charges on Mega here. Okay, you know what? You can just hear the charges on Mega just go up and up and up. I mean, look at the radius of Tech X here. Or this is Tech X Brimstone, by the way. Gonna be down, isn't it? Nope. Wrong again. But going for the timing real quick here, just to build on yesterday's question. 2-1000, 3-1000, drop. He only got a singular foot down. We don't have to worry about losing our key right now because we're gonna go fight Megastan anyway. Just Guppy's collar. If we get Guppy on this, it's lights out. I mean, it's already lights out, but it's even more lights out. Yeah, this one might get an 11 on the Jasonator scale. The dunk rating, because, man. I mean, this looks like a victory lap right now. Like, what we have already looks like a victory lap. Kidney bean is kidney bad. Well, not kidney bad, but it's kidney bad for what we... Excuse me? Was there a bomb in there that I just didn't notice or something? I glanced over to look at OBS real quick, check the levels, and got hit by something. Mongo baby, always welcome to the party. Okay, that was one big old Isaac circle. The biggest of Isaac circles. I'm going to go ahead and use Mega here because I'm tired of dealing with all this crap. I know there's a chest in there, but I want to use Mega on Lamb. Oh yeah, you know we're doing a victory lap. Multi-dimensional baby. I read the second seed off in a second, but first we gotta. There we go. There we go. Egg is already recharged, by the way. An invisible Mullaboom up there. Very cute game. Okay. So, second seed, Sierra November 33 Hotel, Delta Lima Hotel. There's a quick mid-episode reminder if you're enjoying this episode, everybody, or if you just want to help celebrate 1,000 episodes, click the like button. Again, I'd love to see this video. Let's go back. Let's do it old school. Let's go back to the old sub, not sub goal, but like streak goal. 5,000 likes. Get this video. Show your appreciation. Share it. You won't find too many. I don't know how many other YouTubers out there I've done 1,000 episodes on one game, let alone thousands of episodes on one game, except maybe Ryan. And even then, I don't know if Ryan ever got to 1,000 episodes in Afterbirth. He might have. I'm going to take Mom's coin purse here. Another tears up. It's good. Health up is fine. One that makes you larger. All right. We're back to regular Isaac size. Got a mini charge. Look at us. Earth Row is fantastic. We end up going Angel Deals. So we are looking for Guppy. This is going to cost us one soul heart, but it's worth it for the chance to get Guppy here. And we get a 4-1 Krampus fight out of the way. Oh, man, that would have been perfect if it was... If only it was... Okay. Well, then. I was going to say, if only that was Lubbock Cole, but... Wow. This run goes to 11 on the dunk rating. Maybe even more. I don't know, man. This is getting absurd now. So we got to do light side regardless here, as we're looking for the R key, which we are, key, and we still there's still bits and pieces that we are missing. I'd love to get movement speed as well. Be very beneficial to us. It's about the only doo-doo stat that we have left, other than shot speed, which is, I mean, again, if that's your biggest complaint, then I think you're going to be okay. So now what are we looking for? We're looking for, other than movement speed, we're looking for just more damage, I guess. I mean, we'll take basically anything at this point. I don't remember what was inside of our item room, but I remember it being nothing special on Wow, okay. Yeah, we need movement speed. Movement speed is bad. Bad, bad, bad. All kinds of bad here. With PhD, you would think that we would have gotten some speed ups by now, but if not. Yeah, I don't know. I honestly don't know at this point what we're looking for. Mr. Dolly, we're already locked into a devil deal here. Abba dabba ding dong. It is movement speed and damage. It's basically everything that we wanted. Also take little horn here. Think that was Jar Wisps, maybe, or I know it wasn't Epic Fetus. I don't know what that was. I figured this wasn't the right way to go. That's the reason I have not popped Mega yet. But even if we don't get an Omega run here, you know, it was still one hell of a run. I mean, this is one of those seeds that you just gotta play for yourself. A little abba dabba ding dong. You hear the second shots going off there. If you're wondering where that's coming from, it's from Multidimensional Baby. Oh, it was Dr. Fetus. Tigger might be here, but I'd be surprised. More likely here. Yep. So eventually, I mean, I'm hoping that we end up finding the wafer or something. Chaos is what we want now. Booster pack, we don't really care about. We never care about booster pack. If booster pack defaulted to 10 cents instead of 15 cents, it would be an amazing, amazing pickup. I don't really want conjoined, but I'm going to take it anyway. It gives us more C-section babies at basically no penalty. Basically no penalty. The Bible. I'm not going to use our Perthrower on that. I think we can do better. And now we're just covering the entire room. Thank you, Gimpy. By Gimpy, I mean Dumpy. Apparently we weren't done in this room. I thought we were. My mistake. So Sun card, might as well use it. We ain't gonna keep it. Does get rid of Curse of Darkness, which is nice. And, I mean, there's Diplopia. Do we really need Mega anymore? I'm gonna say no. Diplopia gives us a chance for the R key. The double R key. I can see Forever gives us the whole map, which is kind of nice. Also, of course, gives us an automatic entry into the Secret Room and Super Secret Rooms. I think it would be even cooler for a horse pill. I can see Forever would also allow you to get in all locked doors on the level, like a boss trap room. I think that would be neat. Wow, that is just ridiculous damage. And we do get Roid Rage, which is going to give us even more movement speed. So mucormycosis is just gonna add on to the pain rating for the game. That's another. There you go. We need a pain rating guy or girl in the comment section. On a scale of 1 to 10, rate the amount of pain the game is in right now, and being the highest amount of pain. There's all kinds of fun wacky kooky crazy comment streaks that people are coming up with. And thank you to everyone who does, to not only, even if you don't have a comment streak, if you're just leaving comments, I appreciate everything. You all know, yeah, I've been preaching about engagement the last couple of, well, really the last year or so. And, you know, people are very cognizant of how important it is to help grow the channel. And just, you know, it's not only about growing, but it's also just supporting it. And, you know, the Mosh Pit has always been a bastion of YouTube communities. You don't see that level of participation in many YouTube communities at all. Like, I mean, even channels like 10 times the size of us. Like, you don't see that kind of interaction. Usually bots are looking for giveaways or some crap like that. I know that there's a lot of bots obviously going around in the comment section. I'm doing my best to try to get rid of them. Obviously it's just a whack-a-mole game, so I can't take all of them on, but I'm trying to stay on top of it, because, you know, we don't want anything inappropriate in the comments or anything like that. And it should go without saying, if you see a bot comment or if you see someone trying to impersonate me in the comments, obviously don't click on any links, don't go to the profiles, don't do anything, just simply report them and hope that YouTube does something about it, which they probably won't, but what can you do? I mean, that's all that we can do. And to stay vigilant, you know. Same thing goes with Discord as well. There's been a round of like new scams and impersonators and stuff going around on Discord, and you know, I made a message on Monday. Just to let everybody know, you know, I won't ever add anyone just randomly to Discord. You know, always check the username, that sort of thing, and just stay safe. You know, it's for what seems to be a very easy application of advice on the internet. Never ever it's somehow people still fall for this stuff. And it has to set, the obvious has to be stated, and I'll still continue to state that, but obviously don't click on any links that come from places that you don't know, somewhere unannounced, even if they have the same profile picture or whatever, you know. I know that 99.999% of you are tech savvy enough to know not to do these. It's standard common knowledge rules of the internet, right? Are we out of here? Okay. No, if we actually killed it or not. But because there's not a very good amount of verification systems that go on, especially on platforms, you can just pay for the verification. You know, you just have to stay safe. And sometimes people need a nice little gentle reminder. Hey, by the way, don't accept friend requests. Anyone impersonating me or anyone, you know, asking, hey, check out this this crazy giveaway. No. Just don't do it. There's no giveaways. I'm not adding you as a friend. At least not without, like, contacting you beforehand. Yeah, I'm just let people know. Things have changed over the years on the internet. Over the decades at this point. And you always want to make sure that people know, you know. I always try to stay on top of that kind of stuff because I want to keep people in the mosh pit as informed and safe as possible. I have no idea what just hit me. Baron energy, range up. Isaac. That goes mom. There's this list. We don't need any of these, by the way. I could use a Perthrow rune in there, but I'm really hoping that we get a chance for... if we can, just having Arky. We did not get a school bag. So the last place we'll be able to see it is if we get chaos or something like that. Man, oh man. I don't know what's happening on the screen right now, but chocolate milk turned our C-section babies into just balls. So, and now they're getting kind of, it's getting a little crazy. That was weird. All the babies stopped spinning for a second there. That was strange. They're like stuttering. The animation like goes around and around and then stops. And man, oh man, what a very strong run. We do have a sacrifice room, so we can play that down to completion and get the. Key piece that we need for the Mega Stand door. And if anything, even if we don't get an R key, which it doesn't look like we're going to at this point, we could still at least take some sort of solace in knowing that if we get Mega Stand blocked from Delirium, it wouldn't have mattered anyway. There we go. Second key piece is a go. We can go check the library really quickly here. Maybe there's a Book of Shadows or Book of Revelations or something like that in there. I mean, it's really not gonna add any more time onto this run. We are gonna get Bookworm as well, which is nice. It just gives us even more shots to play around with. That's our man, Huel. What do we get? We got Angry Fly. Hooray for Angry Fly. Emperor card. Yeah, at this point, I don't think we need the Perthrow rune. I mean, we could go re-roll the library, I suppose, but what do we really need out of the library at this point? Like, yeah, we can re-roll more books and maybe get the Book of Revelations or Book of Shadows, but we might reroll this. Hang on. Because we got the Pandora's box on Womb 1, this gives us two guaranteed items that we can drop inside of the secret room and maybe have a reroll chance for an R key. This is about the only chance that we get. I don't know if it's there or not. I actually don't know where the secret room is. But we have plenty of bombs, so I mean, we're going to find it. Okay.
Something's wrong. Range up.
Okay, so I'm going to use the Pandora's box. Okay. Movement speed would be nice, but we're going for the gusto here.
Perthrow.
It's spin down die. Turns into Guppy's Eye, which also turns into Binge Eater. I don't remember what item synergizes with spin down die. Now, another thing we could have done is could have diplopia'd the we could have diplopia'd Pandora's box inside of the secret room and rolled again. But we need diplopia for our key. And we don't have a school bag anyway, so. What mind blood bag? We're probably not going to get enough energy to get any of this though. Yeah, I don't think that we're not gonna get another charge anyway, so. But I will say that spin down die probably gives us a better chance of getting us an R key than just having diplopia, so maybe. I mean, we're definitely gonna get another full charge against old Hushy. We get Lusty Blood. Yeah, we can take Lusty Blood. I wouldn't mind Blood of the Martyr and the Nail. We already have Leviathan. Blood of the Martyr is just a straight up damage upgrade. It also activates Horde Babylon, so we can take that. Yeah, I'm fine with that. We'll, instead of going for Diplopia, because we have to get the R key anyway. It doesn't matter if we have Diplopia or not. We still need it. We still need to get the R key in general, so. Yeah, we'll stick with spin down and let's just see what happens. Because there I feel like there's a better chance of us seeing R key if we just get more item pedestals. And because we have Steam Sale now, we can at least buy some stuff in old Hushy's shop and maybe make it. We're gonna have to fight Hush again, unfortunately, but such is the way of the hunt for the Omega run. I would be very excited if we could do an Omega run for episode 1000. It'd be very fitting. On a run that's already in Sano mode. Excuse me? Oh, okay. You just need to do that real quick. Okay. This is an all-timer on the visual doo-doo, though, I will say. Check the devil deal real quick. Bloody Lust. Doesn't really matter. Let's go fight old Hushy. Maybe we'll get lucky. I don't remember what key or what item precedes our key for spin down. But thanks to external information mod, we will, if we see it, then we'll know. Super bandage is not bad. I had a Game Kid and Sack of Pennies spawn, giving us the exact same conclusion. Capricorn's also pretty good. Gonna take Capricorn for the all stats up. This is basically a whole lot of nothing in here. Wouldn't mind super bandages for the HP. We know that we're going to get another full charge on spin down, so this is kind of whatever. Yeah, Hush, Hush is dead. In the quickest way possible, Hush didn't stand a chance. Old Hushy's old daddy. I'm not gonna lie, I'm just gonna use the Emperor card now because we're gonna do a full clear in the chest, because obviously this is where the biggest chance of us getting our key is going to be. And we're gonna have to come back anyway to go fight Megastan, so. Dad's note, which is not death certificate. Sausage. How did we manage to get, again, Oh, no, no. I take it back. So Candy Heart turns into sausage, which obviously is what we want. I also forgot to use it in there. I just wasted basically a full charge in here. Or no, is it King Baby or which? Wait, which one of you turns into sausage? Options does. Okay, very confused. Mr. Mega turns to the D Sizzle. Okay. So because there's no, I mean, we don't need sausage here. Because there's no recourse for getting Arky here, I'm going to reroll this. That before is not bad, but Proptosis would be insane. Because like we don't need any other stats, right? Like we're already set. I'm not taking a gag. Oh, baby. Fortunately, there's no item in there, so. I think what we have to do is we have to go get a full charge on spin down, which was what we just got done doing, and then we need to charge the D6. And hope that we get whatever item precedes Arky in there. Now, I realize I could just go look this up, but I don't want to do that. I don't think I should have to. So deliberately doing a full clear here, just looking for chests, getting charges, etc., etc. Okay, so the D-Sizzle's charged. Let's go back and re-roll the chest room here. And let's take spin down and see what it turns into. Nothing, 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 nothing. I mean, double Brimstone would be pretty insane with this, although I don't know if it actually does anything at this point. The bad thing now is that things just can't even stay alive long enough for me to kill things. So we'll get the second Brimstone over here. With a balance, and doesn't really turn into anything that we care about. We might be able to get one more charge with the D6. But probably not. I mean, Blue Baby might do it, but oh my gosh. Okay. So we did not get a. Ooh, there's a full charge with. Okay, hang on now. There's full charge with the D6 or spin down if we need it. Forget me now. I mean, well, the problem is that's gonna consume our key though. Not our key, but our key, as in, like, our. I think what we do is we get the full charge on the D6 one more time. Let's see what all this turns into here. Pandora's box, and nothing is doable. All right, well, there's no Omega run here, but let's see First off, let's see how fast we kill Megastan. And secondly, let's see if we would have gotten a Delirium Portal anyway, if it would have made a difference with the Archie or not. Oh my god. This is instant. It's instant death. Like, Stanley hasn't even done anything yet. He hasn't even gotten his hands out yet. Yep. And yeah, there you go. Wouldn't have mattered. So, still, what a run. Thank you all very much. 1,000 episodes of Repentance and counting. Oh, man, I do want to say thank you again for all the support over the years. I do appreciate it, everybody. And, yeah, here's to the next 1,000 more. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you click the like button. Let's get this video over 5,000 likes. That would make me feel good about 1,000 episodes and counting. And here's to the next 1,000 in the mosh pit. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Alyssa, Squeegee, and Duckland. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find at patreon.com/invicta.